Hello and welcome to Antenatal Wisdom Downloads. I'm Eva Fernandez and today I'm talking to Amanda Rayment and Dominique Sakoilsky. And the subject we're going to talk about today is why would you want to work in the arena of antenatal teacher training or in fact being a doula? So we're going to start off with Dominique. Why are you working in this arena?
I was birthed, if you like, into this arena by the birth of my first child, who is now 26, so quite a few years ago. And I think that, for me, it's something about the very sort of heart of being a human being, this relational kind of journey that we go on as a parent and as a child as well. It touches something about that's at the very heart of being a human being. And so I think, for me, the opportunity to explore that with others and to heal something both within myself and to offer something from that place to others as well. It just felt like a very, it drew me very strongly.
And Amanda, what about you? What's your experience?
Yes, my experience is, very similar to Dom's, that I was drawn by my own desire, if you like, to discover what family really means and what motherhood means and the relationship of the parent and child that I feel I'm passionate about, and also believe that and have faith that there is such a huge opportunity offered to us in healing that the ideas of parent and child relationship and discovering what is true and real in the parent and child relationship. So yeah, the same as Dominique, just feel like I'm in heaven really, each day working with all the amazing and wonderful opportunities that the women I work with bring forward, with their questions, with their diagnosis, with their situations they want to explore.
And do you think that this is the reason why people have gone on to your course and why you attract those students?
Yeah, I mean, it always makes sense, doesn't it, that the people who knock on our door are going to be the people who offer assistance to us and we are able to offer assistance to others. I mean, this is what is at the heart of giving and receiving, that there is that beautiful exact equality, if you like, between the one that knocks on our practice room door and the one that is the so-called practitioner, that the exact same opportunity of healing, of seeing differently, of diving deeper into love, whatever words we want to use, the form of the parent and child relationship, of antenatal care, of parenting, is a form that speaks to us, if you like, that we're passionate about, that makes our hearts sing. So yes, I would say definitely that the people who are attracted and say yes to training through Antenatal Wisdom share that same passion and enthusiasm that we have for parenting and family life, and it may not be in the form of passion and enthusiasm, it may be in a yearning to wanting to discover more, but the bottom layer would always be the same of wanting to see family life differently.
So Dom, do you think that in some ways doing the Antenatal Wisdom course is your own healing experience, and when you've done that then you can go on and help other people to heal?
And I think it's ongoing, obviously. I don't think it ever ends. I mean, it's true to say that some people have done Antenatal Wisdom course in order to take some time and explore their own healing, and have never had the intention to actually be working in the arena of pregnancy and birth, but more because they want to heal something in their own experience of being a parent or being a child, being in family life, you know. And then other people, yes, really do want to go out and extend that. But I suppose there's something there for me in the equality of the relationship, the equality of the relationship between us and our students, and then the equality of the relationship between our students and the clients that they work with. You know, we're not setting ourselves up as experts who are going to deliver information to people that will be the key, if you like, to them having a certain experience. Of course, you know, on the course we offer, you know, good, solid physiological and psychological, anatomical information, and we share of our experiences of having worked in this arena for a long time. But we will always include the fact that the students, or if you're, you know, working out there with pregnant women, the clients will be bringing something that is the sort of most valuable thing that we will be working with, and that will be valuable both for the practitioner and the client themselves. So there is a sort of shared place, if you like, where we're undoing stuff that gets in the way of really inhabiting that place of freedom and love and authenticity in this journey of birth and parenting.
Amanda, did you have anything else to say about why you think some people are attracted to your course in a self-healing sort of way?
Yes, I also feel that the message, if you like, of antenatal wisdom is that anything is possible, that every opportunity gives us that opportunity to dive deeper and deeper into love. So I would also say that is very contagious, if you like, that particularly for practitioners, that many of the obstacles practitioners come up against that I've heard when I've worked in the arena of supervision of practitioners is that they feel that they're not good enough, or that they feel that they don't have enough information, or they feel that they do their training in their particular craft, and then the setting up of practice, if you like, of setting up and putting the plaque outside saying I am this, I am that, come and knock on my door is pretty scary. And what I feel antenatal wisdom offers is another way, if you like, of a discovery that as Dom just said just now, they don't have to have a head filled with intellectual knowledge. That, and of course, some intellectual knowledge is offered on antenatal wisdom. It needs to be, because we're an accredited training and we're a postgraduate training as well. So that does need to be there. But a lot of this information, as we all know, can be found on the internet very easily, as well as in books and also through direct experience. There are lots of different ways. What antenatal wisdom offers is a discovery of trusting themselves. And then in that desire to trust themselves, they offer this to their clients. Not that they have to already deeply trust themselves, just that little willingness to open to trusting what is real and true within themselves. Then this is what they begin to offer to those that come and work with them, is that yes, it is safe to trust yourself to become a mother. It is safe to trust that you have everything within you to meet every scenario you can imagine is going to come forward on this incredible journey of parenting. Yes, you can say yes to trusting yourself. You may not know how, you may not know even how to begin, but just the willingness to open to that discovery as to how to will transform the whole parent and child relationship.
Thank you. So now, talking about the actual course itself, I mean, people probably interested in knowing what they're going to be up for learning when they do this course. Dom, can you just talk us through the modules and what?
Yes, so the first module starts with Prayer of the Heart, which is kind of an exploration in a way as to, you know, why are you doing this, and exploring what it is in your heart's calling, if you like, that is bringing you into this work, and really understanding that for yourself. The second module is all about active birth, looking at the pelvis and the hormones and understanding something about birth physiology. The third module is looking at communication. So really accepting birth as a relational, pregnancy and birth as, you know, deeply relational experience, and understanding something about communication, whether that's communicating with the baby or whether that's communicating in the couple relationship or just communicating with our clients, but really looking at giving and receiving in that way from each other. And then the fourth module is the experience of pregnancy and birth. In pregnancy and looking at the state of pregnancy and how we support that. The fifth module is looking at herbs for the antenatal and postpartum period, and ways for well-being with a lot of Amanda's incredible herbal wisdom. And then the sixth module is actually from my book, The Seven Secrets of Joyful Birth, where, you know, I take people on a bit of a journey, if you like, or a process through those seven states. And then they can then take their clients also through that process to understand something of themselves in that journey. So quite a sort of psychological journey. And then the seventh module is teaching from the heart. So it's about, you know, getting out there, whether as a doula or a teacher, really looking at ways to support your practice and sort of looking at resistances so that you can free yourself from that. And like Amanda says, lots of people do lots of trainings and are really skilled practitioners, but they don't always look at what gets in the way, or get the support, if you like, of what gets in the way of them getting out there and making a really flourishing practice. And we really love to put attention to that too. And in fact, we do some, you know, we offer face-to-face days as well, and one of our face-to-face days is about setting up practice for those people who wish to kind of really explore that and take it further.
So it's really interesting hearing that, because I can hear from what you're saying that there's more to this than just what you get in a normal sort of NHS, we want from that class, for example. Do you think, Amanda, that what you offer is well over above what you might just get from your local midwife and NHS service?
Yes. I mean, I feel that a training to be an antenatal teacher or a doula is such an amazing opportunity to really, if you have that passion and enthusiasm for working in this arena, if the parent and child relationship, pregnancy and birth and postpartum excites you, then, you know, what more wonderful way than working with other women who are starting out on that journey or are partway through the journey or whatever, to be able to support in a way that feels authentic to you, while at the same time offering to your clients what it is that they believe they need. So, you know, one of our questions in the last module that Dom just spoke of, I think one of the questions is, what does it mean to teach from the heart? This is what our course offers, is a lot of self-discovery, really, a lot of questions that we believe support you in diving deeper to be able to extend to others what excites you, what your enthusiasms are, and what it is that you're learning to teach yourself in a way. And for me, it's one of the most profound moments in being a human is when another being asks another being for assistance. And of course that doesn't just occur in the antenatal world. Of course, that occurs in every moment of all our lives. Someone can step forward and ask us for assistance, or we can be the one asking for assistance. And the potential for healing and happiness that is there in that moment, if one of those, it only needs one of those people that come together to have even a little willingness to have ears willing to hear eyes willing to truly see and to dive deeper, as we are often saying on Antenatal Wisdom, into love, into what is true and what is real. And there is the exact same opportunity for the practitioner as there is for the client in that profound moment of one person asking for assistance. It may look like the client is the one that needs to be assisted. It may look like it's the client that needs to be fixed. But what we bring on Antenatal Wisdom is actually, this is just appearance. Dive deeper than this. Look at what is really being asked for. And yes, we have discovered for ourselves that it brings an immense relaxation in our work and an excitement and an enthusiasm. Would you agree, Dom?
Absolutely, yes. I think you've just said it beautifully.
But what a wonderful way to work. I mean, in fact, recently I was speaking with somebody who is just stepping out, if you like, into the world of being a practitioner, and was concerned that, you know, that the client may have symptoms, diagnosis, situations, questions that she just wouldn't know how to answer. And when we looked at this together, you know, the place we came to was that the bottom layer, if you like, that everybody coming forward into our classes or our one-to-one practice is is really what they're underneath all the diagnosis, all the symptoms, all the questions, all the desires of how they want their pregnancy and birth to be. The bottom layer for all of us is that desire to want to know that we're loved and that we're lovable and that we're capable of loving others. So in a way, that is the role of the antenatal teacher or the doula, is to offer that to the woman, to say, you're whole and perfect and wonderful, sweetheart. You know, this, okay, yeah, it may look like mistakes are going to be made along the way, but it doesn't matter. It doesn't change for a moment the exquisite beauty of how you are, of who you are. I didn't mean how you are, I meant who you are. And that is the gift. And, you know, that for me, that's a place of relaxation, rather than having to fix a so-called client, because it's not possible to fix anybody else. We all know that.
So it sounds like self-acceptance from both the teacher's point of view and the client's point of view is a big thing that you get from this training and from being a teacher on for Antenatal Wisdom.
Yes. And it certainly isn't that we don't look like, some of our Skype sessions are dedicated to case studies, aren't they, Dom? And students can bring forward particular teaching situations that they're finding challenging, and we will look at those, won't we?
Absolutely. You know, it's not, I wouldn't want people to think in any way that it doesn't engage with whatever's there. And if that's, you know, it can be quite a pragmatic, a very pragmatic course as well. And people will be met in different ways, won't they? Will need to be met in different ways. So we certainly engage with anything that comes up with people's practice.
Yes.
Yes, absolutely.
Yeah.
So thank you, Amanda. And thank you, Dom, for informing us all about the training. And people can find more information about the training via the link that I'll put on the bottom of this recording. So thank you.
Thank you, Eva. And thanks, Amanda. Lovely to chat.
Yeah.